Hi friends, I'm Kat, and today we're going to talk about the 80-20 principle. Are you familiar with the 80-20 rule? You've probably heard of it. It's also called the Pareto principle, and it's a way that we go about trying to separate the vital few from the trivial many. So some examples of the Pareto principle or the 80-20 rule, let's say, 80% of the trips that you take in your car are to 20% of the places that you might actually go. Another way to think about it is 80% of the dinners that I cook use only 20% of the ingredients in my pantry, and that's actually probably true. This idea of the vital few versus the trivial many, it's an incredibly useful principle that we can use to evaluate business processes as well. So I want to show you an example of a data set that I have here in SAS. I'm in SAS Studio. Everything I'm showing you in this video will work in SAS Studio, whether you're using a locally installed SAS, or you're using SAS Via, or you're using Via for Learners, or you're using SAS On Demand. All of this will work the same way. So I'm working with a data set called Complaints. And we have two different locations, A and B, and we also have the complaints that were received about that location, facility maintenance, waiting room time, food, and so forth. And we also have the frequency of each of those complaints. This is one of several different ways that you can structure a data set. You could just have a list of the complaints and the date, and that would work just as well. But here we have it pre-summarized into frequencies. And what I want to be able to do is create a chart that shows what the different causes or the different complaint reasons are in a way that puts the tallest bar first and the shortest bar last, so that I can separate the vital few from the trivial many. To do that, I'm going to use a procedure in SAS called Proc Pareto. In Proc Pareto, the first thing I'm going to do is create a vertical bar Pareto chart. That means that my bars will be vertical of complaint, and the frequency count is going to be captured with the freq equals option. So freq equals is an option, and then this capital F freq, that is the variable name. I also have max n cat equals 10, just saying I don't want to show more than 10 categories, but I could change that to anything I wanted. I don't even have to put a max there. And there are going to be some default features that show up on this Pareto chart that make this really easy to do this kind of analysis. So because we think of this as an 80-20 principle, a lot of times people want to try to identify what are the categories that account for cumulatively 80% of the events. Well, in this case, there is a cumulative percent curve on the right-hand axis, and that cumulative percent is reached when we get out to maybe 5 complaints. And it does look like the first 2 complaint reasons are waiting room time and facility maintenance. But this is not paying any attention to the fact that there are 2 different locations. When you have 2 locations, they might be completely independent processes, in which case we should probably evaluate them using a by variable. So if I process this by location, then we get 2 different Pareto charts. We get one for location A and we get one for location B. So for location A, the number one cause of complaint was waiting room time, and the second was lack of information. If we look at location B, the number one cause was facility maintenance, and the second one is staff courtesy, followed by waiting room time. So they look a little bit different. Another way that we could look at this, though, is by doing a comparative Pareto chart. So I used a by statement here to get separate Pareto charts for each group. But maybe what I want to do is actually get my Pareto charts with the A and B compared to each other on the same scale, so that the complaints are in the same order for both. I would do that by using a class variable instead of a by variable. And that's what we're doing here. So let's check out the vertical bar chart where class equals location, and I've gotten rid of the by statement. And this time you can see that the order of the columns is set by the first level of the class variable, in this case location A. And location B shows a very different profile than location A does. This is one way of creating these Pareto charts. There are a lot of really cool things you can do. You can, for example, tell it that you don't want to see the cumulative percent curve. Maybe you want to create a Pareto chart with horizontal bars instead of vertical bars. Maybe you don't want to see the legend down at the bottom because you're okay with that ordering. You know what 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 are. Lots of options that you can put on the Pareto procedure. And I put a few of them here. So I asked for no curve. I asked for in legend, and I also set max in cat equals 8. So it's showing only 8 causes. And it just to show you, there are lots of things you can do. If you check out the resources below, you'll find documentation for the Pareto procedure. You'll also find some links to some other interesting stuff, including the SAS QC course. And so that's all I've got to show you today. And if you like this video, please give me a like, give me a thumbs up. Also, put a comment down below. What are you using Pareto charts to evaluate? Where do you see the 80-20 principle in practice? I love to hear from you. I love knowing that you're here watching our videos here on the SAS Users channel. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.